Man, Dar, for college, full disclosure, don't go to a state school if all you're going to do is get an associate's degree. If you're only going for a two-year degree, go to a fucking community college. You will save so much money. And then if you, like, decide you want to go for, you know, a bachelor's or whatever, then go to, like, a state college or whatever. But for just an associate's, I would never recommend anyone go to a state college for that. Go to a community college, you're gonna save so much money. Like, I went... It would have been 2009 when I started college. A couple years out of high school. And my first 2 years cost me, I want to say, $5,000 total. And then to get my bachelor's was another 20. So, keep that in mind. Like... Eh, and like, I could have done it cheaper. Admittedly, part of the reason it was so expensive was that I was getting like living costs in there and stuff. So, do what you think is reasonable. And like, you know, if you want to start with a 2 year degree and like you have plans to want to go for a master's or whatever, you don't have to do it all at once. Like, that's the other thing. And also have an idea of what you're going in for. Or just take a lot of general courses. Like, there's nothing wrong with just going to college and just taking a couple classes. You don't have to necessarily be working towards anything. Just go for knowledge. Like, that can be a good thing too. I've actually wanted to be taking some like welding classes and stuff. Just haven't found the time. And we have a cave. That's a lot of zvarts. I have a Scroll of Grease, which would be tempting, but I'm not gonna cast it. Instead, I'm just gonna kinda let the melees turn these enemies into mulch! Yeah, I did 2 runs through college as well. I can totally understand what you're going for there, Mel. Like, I got pushed into it right after I got out of high school, and like, after doing 12 years of school, I wanted a fucking break. And I did like 2 semesters and was like, nope, I'm not fucking doing this, I'm done. And basically, essentially failed out, and then I went back and actually was like, okay, I'm gonna learn this time, and there you go. Time actually went pretty quick. I hate electives! Like, I had to take a fucking speech class, which, as far as I'm concerned, is like a literal waste of time and money. But hey, that's how college works. Can we sleep here? Aw, yes!
You have
needed saving.
I can, but try. I'll do my best.
Oh my god. Vectorial mathematics. That's one of the reasons that I didn't go into programming courses specifically, is because, like, I loved math when I was younger, and then I got to high school and I had a really terrible math teacher, and they killed any desire I ever had to want to do anything regarding math ever again. And any programming course, like, that you're gonna take, man, you've gotta take physics and calculus and all this shit, and I was just like, nope, not gonna use any of that. You know, I program shit for, like, TIG welders, you know? They don't need this kind of stuff here. I'm not, like, programming Doom or something. I don't need a physics engine. I was just like, fuck. All right, Darius, if you want to get into the trades, you're obviously in, like, not necessarily gonna want to look at a community college for that. You'd look for trade schools. But like, just look around for places offering apprenticeships for people that have no fucking idea what they're doing. And just ask around. Like, asking is free. An ogre mage! I would bet money we are fucked right now. Because this dude's invisible, first off.
Yes, sir.
Where are you, buddy? There you are. These are high-level enemies. But yeah, when it comes to that kind of stuff, like, if you want to get in the trades, like, first off, like, that's good money, because nobody does it. And there we go! We literally got magic missile to death. There was no way for me to avoid that. I just, like, game over. Let's try this again. But yeah, I've contemplated going to trade school for something like doing electrical work or something. The money's good, the work isn't, you know, I mean, the hours can be bad. But I don't know. It's just a case of, like, again, I just haven't had the time to do it. Like, my wife's actually been talking about going back to college recently, and part of me is tempted to be like, yeah, okay, I'll go with you, but I don't know. I don't feel like I have enough time to do everything I want to do as it is. Oh my god, fuck off, Noober. I will drag you out of town and murder you. Hey, Edwin!
Go no further. I require the services of your group.
Yes.
I'll do as you ask.
Do nicely.
Hey, so she's dead, buddy. So, what do we have to do? She's already dead. Can I just be like... Can I just talk to Edwin and tell him that she's dead? So the witch is dead. I would have thought her more formidable to be so far from her homeland. Why then was she here? Checkmate. I begin to doubt whether the input was all that vital. Still, someone think for the troubles in order, if only to appease them. We never agreed on a fixed price. Your payment shall be 1 year of my services as a wizard. I suppose that shall suffice. Okay.
Do my best.
We now have the party that I'm... Well, no, I take that back. We do not have the party that I'm tentatively going to finish this game. We still need to get Viconia yet. I am however gonna save it. An attempt to avoid Noober. Fuck off, Noober. Nobody wants you. The only thing less valuable than Noober is, like, a cow. Let's see here. Okay, I gotta know. Okay, let's do this. Did it work? I can't tell.
You are so
I gave him the wrong one, didn't I? Yeah, that's the Belt of Antipode. Oh, don't tell me I sold the frickin' nope, there it is. I was gonna say. Oh, there we go. Edwina!
Need of me?
What has happened to you, Edwin? Naturally, I have to talk to him and see what his thoughts on this are. He has nothing to say, apparently. That's okay. He can stay as Edwina for a while. And by for a while, I mean the rest of the game. Okay, so we gotta do stuff in the mines. Yes, Minsk. First shopping.
We shall hold here. You look tired.
Yes, Dorn. Don't worry, guys. I'll get you your nappy. I'll even spring for the expensive room. I just have to do shopping first.
Your business has been poor, what with the iron shortage and all.
Okay. It's a lol gem. Our currency is looking good here, and we got a couple bandit scouts. I'm gonna go ahead and vendor. Excellent. Splint mail can go. This freaking Belt of Antipode, I don't know if I'm ever gonna use it, but damn it. Edwina, yeah, man, I wanna say it's in Baldur's Gate 2? That, like, they actually change his name and stuff to Edwina, and I think he has, like, a custom portrait and shit. It's great. The Brawling Hands, oh, these are some monk gloves. That's probably vendor trash. Gauntlets, oh, these are actually Gauntlets of Dexterity. Equipped abilities, Dex 18. Well, fuck. Okay. And a Wakizashi and Small Shield plus one. Sweet. That was actually a good haul then. My nether region is appeased. All right, I'm gonna give these, I think, to Chunk, along with this. Because this should bring his AC down by, like, I think, I was gonna say 3 or 4 points. I would have guessed 4, but I'll take 3. And a Wakizashi plus one. Very nice. So as to hit is a 17 and a 22. Very nice. And this magic shield, which I guess can just go on Khalid for now. We'll eventually be giving it to Viconia because she's going to be a probably like flail, if I had to guess. Flail and shield. Yeah, Dar. Like,
you
fuck.
You have need of me?
Yeah, wait until you see stuff like Gauntlets of Ogre Power and shit. Like, you can get Gauntlets of, I think, Cloud Giant Strength. They give you a strength of 24. And back in second edition, the highest your strength could go was 25. Like, it's nuts, some of the magic items in these games. Okay, so everybody's rested. I'm a quick save. How are we looking on XP? Everyone is getting there. Like, we are all nearing level ups, even Chunk. Well, Edwina gets nothing, but that's okay. He has shit spells anyways. All right, I'm gonna give him Larlox. I'm gonna give him Shocking Grasp is like vendor trash. Charm Person. And Grease. I am going to have to check because he's a conjurer. Back in, alright, in newer editions, if you play a specialist wizard, you get to pick what your, like, opposed schools are. Back in the day, you did not. So I don't know. Here we go. Divination. So he can't cast divination spells, which is, as far as this game concerns me, not a lot. Like, identify, but we have Czar for that. So that's okay. And I want to say Chromatic Orb is actually a conjuration spell. Or no, it's evocation. I am wrong. Czar is a necromancer, so Larlock's Minor Drain is like a good thing for him to cast, kind of. It doesn't require a save, but every little bit, I guess. Okay, so let's adjust the party. Let's go ahead and flip his spells out, because Color Spray is nice, but it also affects my party. And that makes me sad. Alright, take the peasant room. We have spells, we're quick saving. I could demonstrate Boo's speak, well, naturally. It's the best sound effect in the world. Okay, prohibitive spells, yeah, never made sense to me that they didn't keep it how they did in 2E. I agree, because, like, everybody would just prohibit, like, I don't know, divination, depending on the kind of mage you were playing. But yeah, like, it just seemed better that way. But then I also think that, like, a lot of people a lot of people in 3rd edition is like, you know, clerics are overpowered because they have access to their whole spell list. Back in 2nd edition, clerics got spells based on their deity, and they had access to these things called spheres, and that's how you determined what spells your cleric could cast. So, like, a cleric of a war god, for example, would be able to cast, you know, combat buffing spells and so on, whereas a cleric of a god of the farms probably wouldn't. And it was a really good balancing act. And then they got rid of it in 3rd edition for reasons.
Hey,
I'm glad. Glad to hear that, Cap.
Can I help you? I'll do my best.
Let's see, do we have anything to the east? The carnival, let's see. Man, I'd almost be tempted to pick up Branwyn just temporarily, but I really don't want to pay for a scroll of flesh to stone. How far to the north? Let's go back to the friendly arm in. Because I'm not on any time limits right now, I don't believe. So, we're gonna see about getting Viconia and see how much farther our party's reputation can fall before people start whinging about it. Oh my god. That'd be great, Captain. That would just be great. Stupid reasons. You're not wrong, Dar. Like, there are, like, that's something that I've wanted to do with, like, my revised rules, was bring spheres back, but it is a lot of work. Like, going through spells and figuring out, alright, nope, you've got custom AI, don't you? Yeah, not anymore. It's a lot of work to go through, like, all the spell books and stuff, picking out, you know, this is what clerics of this sphere would be able to cast and so on. But one of these days I'll get around to it. But it's not a rush. It's like I also want to go through and tweak how, like, just direct damage spells work, because in 1st and 2nd edition they were really viable because things didn't have boatloads of hit points. Then 3rd edition happened and everything got boatloads of hit points. Okay, there's nothing to the west. So I gotta figure out some way to buff up stuff like fireballs and whatnot to make them viable, essentially. It's like, why would you cast, you know, Cone of Cold when you could cast Phantasmal Killer or something. Alright, let's go up here. I think this is the Ancake Farms, which, if that's the case, I don't want to particularly be here. So we're gonna have to be careful. Oh no, I'm gonna skirt this as best I can, because I know those suckers are up there, and I would bet. How did I manage that? Minimizing my party on the side. Although that's kind of cool that they let you. Man, I'm just gonna be hardcore, and this is how we're gonna play from now on. I don't need to see hit point totals or buttons to access my inventory or anything. I just just need my cleric. That's all I need. Which is why I'm going east, hoping to find... Oh, but it looks like they're going to... No, we got a transfer here. That's what I want. Eh? There's a Peld Vale. That's what we want. All right, quick save.
I'll do my best.
Khalid, I'm going to endeavor not to get you killed. Because you're okay and you're going to die in the sequel anyways. Oh, hidden barrel loot and a fish. 10 gold pieces. All right. Is that, nope, not a hostile bear. The temptation, however, to make it a hostile bear outweighs anything resembling good sense that I had. Hit it with the magic door. We'll hit it with a Larlock's minor drain. And it's blinded. Amazing. And down it goes. Freaking 420 experience points. I'll take it. Yes, guys, I know. I'm trying to let you rest, but the game's stuck in combat. Don't blame me. Jeez. So needy. All I ask is they kill at my whim, and even that they complain about. Well, how can I kill if I've not slept for 82 hours, they say. To which I just throw bottles of Nuka-Cola at their heads. And like, if it seems like I'm kind of being a little scattered, oh my god, I'm getting my casters up in the melee, which is a bad idea. If it seems like my play is kind of scattered, like I'm all over the place, it's purely because I just want to get my party put together here before we actually start working on the main quest. Like, I'm not going to be a jackass for the entirety of this. Most of it, yes, but not all of it. I just want to get my group together. And we will carry on. It's gonna suck. This is a giant spider, a huge spider. It's gonna suck that Viconia and Edwin are gonna be a pretty good chunk of XP behind. Long term, though, it shouldn't be that bad. Oh, it's killing Chunk. Chunk, get out of there. Haha! Chunk is poisoned. Drink a healing potion. Oh no, I think Chunk's probably gonna die. Is Chunk gonna die? Is Chunk gonna die? Am I gonna be salty? It's coming it! Isn't it? There it goes. I hate poison in D&D games. We're gonna throw stuff that poisons you like 30 hours of gameplay before you have any choice or chance, I should say, or ability to cure said poison. Hashtag game balance. And the Archpriest of Father Fire Lord, fear my Waterbolt spell. Yeah, that's exactly it. And that's the kind of stuff that you won't get in the second edition because your Fire Mage will be throwing, or your Fire Cleric will be throwing, like, Flame Strikes, not Aquaeus Bolts or whatever. It's spicy water. That's the trick. He just, like, adds, you know, crushed red pepper flakes to the water to make it a little spicier. I don't know. I'm just looking for a cleric. I just need a healing battery, and that's it. And maybe a source of bless spells. Scald is in fact really dangerous in Pokemon. However, are the Pokemon that used it clerics of water gods, I ask you? She's out here somewhere. Hey, Ted. What's up? Hey there, city folks. What in the name of Lavender takes you this far from home? We're adventurers! You see, I have an uncle who thought himself some kind of hero, had a sword, shield, a whole bit, got himself killed. See? Going off to kill some sort of beastie with all his buddies. Something went wrong. Beastie figured he was coming to set a trap for him. So now they're him and his buddies trudging through the wilderness on their way to the monster slayer. Then all of a sudden, bam! Smack! Monster leaps out and starts ripping off arms and legs. When my pop found his brother, there was nothing left but a big pile of rotten meat. We gotta be going now. crazy people telling us stories about how their relatives got disemboweled. Oh, hey. A Black Talon Elite. Who are they attacking? Minsk. All right. I can work with that. Oh! Damn! Seriously, dude? You gotta kill him? With your bullshit arrows? I'm salty. How much money do we have? 1,000? I don't think it will be that expensive to res Minsk, so I'm actually, I think, going to leave him dead. And we will go back to town and just res him.
I can but try.
Ideally, we will be able to find... I think she's in this northwest corner here. Heh.
Help me.
It honestly wouldn't surprise me if it was a reference or something, Dar. Help me. If you don't help me, they'll kill me. Who are you? My name is Viconia. I'm not from around here. Thank you so much. All right. Who are they?
Can I help you?
What's the Millennium Falcon? Sir's large. All right. So who are they and what are they trying to do? I don't see anyone, Viconia. Unless I need to kick Khalid out of the party. Let's find out, shall we? I'm going to take this and your armor and these. Here, we'll just put it on the ground and I'll just pick it up after. It's quicker that way. All right, Khalid, you are no longer needed. Bye, Khalid. Yeah. I don't really give a shit about what Garayan would say. Nope, she's still...
Try to keep up.
I think normally there's like some mercenaries that attack us, but they're not. We'll reload. All right.
Do my best.
We'll poke around a little bit, see if we can't find anybody that wants to die.
I serve the Flaming Fist.
Ah. Step aside, I'm a member of the Flaming Fist. The woman you're harboring is wanted for the murder of the foulest sort. She is a dark elf. It should be obvious that she is evil. She's done nothing wrong. You'll have to get through us, my friend. You'll be foolish. I represent the law of this region by protecting her. You'll be just as guilty as she. I guess that's too bad for us. Stupid decision for harboring a murderer. I sentence you all to death.
Again, my actions are yours.
Okay.
So
minor drain. This dude's wearing plate mail, so I imagine he's probably going to be kind of a challenge to hit.
You need me.
And I don't want him beating on Chunk, which it looks like. Oh, and he's a spell. Never mind. All right.
You have need of me?
What did she hit him with? I don't know why he went down like that. Blindness doesn't do that. Unconscious. I don't know. Because Zar's not going to be able to drop people unconscious yet. He's only level 1. I don't know. I don't know. All right, now we need to strip Khalid so that I can pass his gear on here. And I'm taking your helm. Man, imagine Minsk's surprise. He's gonna wake up with a drow in the party. And the healing potion, Khalid. All right.
You have me.
Well, still like on you. Thank you. I know you may not be willing to give me a chance because of my dark skin. I am a drow, but if you give me a chance, you won't regret it. Can I join with you? I need friends now more than ever. Sure. I won't disappoint you, I promise. And bye, Khalid. Alright.
Can I help you?
Yeah. Alright, so now we have Viconia, who's actually pretty beefy. 12 hit points. Nice.
A rare display of intelligence, undoubtedly fleeting.
Shut up, Edwin! Quit being a smartass. Or I'm gonna beat you with that belt. Alright, so if I recall, her strength is shit. Yeah. Keeping her geared is going to probably pose a problem.
Early to rise so we can be wealthy and wise. Healthy too.
Why can she not? Oh, I was gonna say, why can't she wear plate mail? Strength requirement. Wow. I can't think of a character I've ever had that be an issue with. It's okay. She's got a high dexterity, so that's actually, for the time being, going to be a really good source of AC for her. Yeah, look at that. Freaking negative two. Best AC in the party. Freaking dex, guys. It's how you win. And she's barely under light encumbrance. Okay. So, ankake plate. That's all Minsk's crap. And this is all just general stuff we found. Alright! Cool!
I will listen. For now. Try.
It's almost, it's taken essentially the entire stream, but we now have our party. That counts for something. See, she's got... Oh, that's the unconsciousness. She hit that dude with command. Alright. Apparently, one round of sleeping was enough. And, yeah, he died. Grab Bless. And... Sanctuary can be pretty great. Duration 4 rounds. I'd give her Shillelagh, but it just doesn't last long enough. But yeah, you can see right here. The sphere on Shillelagh is a combat and a plant sphere spell, where something like Doom is the charm sphere, and Cure Light Wounds is healing. That's great. Nobody brought ale, alas. I think that's an okay loadout for spells for her for now. And we're just leaving Khalid, like, naked out here. With the corpse of an Amish guard. Just like, good luck, Khalid, you're on your own. Alright, so you want to go back down to Neshkel, because there is a temple here. I was going to say, I bet we're going to get ambushed. It's unsurprising. It is, however, kobolds, which can be kind of dangerous. You can set her script. Standard attack. I don't want her casting anything or doing anything unless I tell her to. And apparently Czar just got gibbed and I didn't even notice it. Damn it. I'm not paying for two resurrections. Where's the autosave? Freaking squishy wizards. Oh, come on. You have been waylaid by okay. So irritating.
Speak and be gone.
You go there. Nope. Go down there. You go there.
What is it now?
Oh, Edwin, you're so surly. It's adorable.
Run if you
all right, these things are kobolds, so they're squishy as hell. In D&D, like, back in second edition, these were one of the few monsters that actually had a penalty to their hit point rolls. Much better. I just had to take, you know, some time and think. Novel.
Yes.
Ahead and loot. I can't imagine there's gonna be a whole heck of a lot here worth anything, but we might as well stock up because it's gonna cost to res Minsk. I don't think it'll be too expensive, but I honestly don't remember. Normally you end up having to res a couple characters, so I'm not, oh man, we barely traveled at all. Give me the friendly arm so that I can at least quick save. And back on the road. Cause like we're gonna start getting not encumbered, but tired and stuff. Fatigue. Sure, it took 1 day and 4 hours.
Olza, may darkness prevail.
Lyconia, you shouldn't be saying that out loud. The peasants will freak the fuck out. And did they change her portrait? I don't remember this being her portrait in this. I might just be misremembering, because I'm, like, when I think of Lyconia's portrait, I think of the one in Baldur's Gate 2. But this portrait looks like something out of Neverwinter Nights. I don't know. Hey there, priest. Yeah. Services. I need freaking... Where is it? Raise dead for this idiot. 100 gold. All right. Oh, prices differ. Oh, 200 gold for elves. This is actually interesting. Because back in second edition, like, one of the reasons that it was bad to play elves, like, you were immortal, essentially. You would almost never die of old age. You couldn't be raised from the dead back in old editions of D&D if you were an elf. Because essentially the reason elves didn't sleep and they went into their meditative trances is because, like, they didn't have souls or something. I don't know. But yeah, so that explains why it's more expensive to res her. 100 gold for a raised dead, though, is very reasonable. Alright, so we got Minsk back. Naked Minsk returns. Oh my god, Viconia is going to be leading the party with her kingly 12 hit points. I don't know where I sit on that, but okay. Alright, Minsk. There's your gear. Try not to freaking bite it again.